Hi, everyone. Welcome to another episode of the Yarn and You Girl podcast. I'm Janine, also known as Yarn and You Girl. And if you're looking for me on the internet, you can find me on Ravelry as Yarn and You Girl, on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter as Yarn and You. And then you can also check out the website, which is yarnandyou.com, where I've got yarn, obviously, and project bags and a few patterns and some needles and things like that. So, check it out. You can also find show notes there on the website or also in the Ravelry group page, which is the Yarn and You Girl podcast group under the groups tab in Ravelry. So if you're not a part of that already, go over there and join in. That way you'll be kept, you know, up to date on all of the knit-alongs that we might be doing or any giveaways and things like that. So I hope, today is November 29th. It's Tuesday. I'm a little late. I usually would have podcasted yesterday, but things with the holiday this last week, it was a bit crazy. And so getting things kind of organized and ready to go, I wasn't quite set up for that just yet. But I'm here today, if not a day late, no big deal. And I hope for everybody here in the United States that you had a good Thanksgiving holiday. I had a pretty good Thanksgiving holiday as well, except for the fact that my turkey, it just didn't turn out as well as I was hoping. It had, I don't know if I put the probe thermometer in the wrong place or my probe thermometer's battery was low. I swear I put new batteries in. But the breasts got cooked, but the rest of the dark meat did not get cooked. So it was kind of a disaster in that respect, but we had a ham and we had lots of other food, so it was fine. It was just super disappointing. So we had ended up cutting off the breasts because they were completely done and stuck the rest of the turkey back in the oven in the hopes that it would cook. But it was, you know, it turned out fine. It was just a little disappointing, especially when you have that many people come over. You really want your Thanksgiving to kind of go off, to go off without a hitch. So, you know, whatever. I'm going to go get another turkey, though, because I am determined. I have cooked a turkey before, and it has turned out fine, and there's something wrong with this turkey. It wasn't me. I swear it was the turkey. No, I don't know, but I'm determined to get my turkey mojo back, so I'm going to have another kind of mini Thanksgiving where I can redeem myself in the turkey cooking aspect. So I hope you all had a great holiday week. We had lots of family over here, and we played lots of games and watched a lot of football, which was really cool. And, you know, it was just great. And excuse me if I'm a little yawny today. I got up super early and I didn't sleep very well last night. So I might be yawning throughout the podcast. So I apologize for that. I will do my best to stay as alert and keep you guys, keep an upbeat and positive attitude for today. I do want to say thank you to everyone who showed up at the Puyallup Quilt Craft and Sewing Festival. I had such a great time, and it was so much fun. So if you were one of my visitors there, thank you. I appreciated you guys. I met great people. It was so much fun. I was completely exhausted at the end of it, but I'm done with the shows for the rest of the year. Oh, my goodness. Whew, that was a big one. I'm done with shows for the rest of the year, and so I've got my room all back to normal, and everything in the house is starting to get back to normal, which is great. While we were gone, I ended up having the entire downstairs of the house and the upstairs hallway here repainted the interior. We've lived in this house now for 8 years, and the interior has never been repainted, and it's all the same kind of taupey color in the room here in the bedrooms. It was just like across the board the same color. It's fine. It's perfectly neutral great color, no big deal, except for it was a little dark. And then the type of paint that they had used on the original, I think it was a flat paint. So if you tried to wash the walls, it would kind of come off and fade a little bit. And I had a big giant black lab who used to rub himself along the wall as he would walk down the stairs. And there's like, you know, this giant, like, greasy level, like, right at his shoulder height that I could never clean off, never. And then with the kids and stuff over the past couple of years, you know, there's crayon on the wall and just little stuff that's gross and not really easy to clean with this particular type of paint. So I had the entire interior of the house painted downstairs. So when I came back from the show, that was, you know, the house was still kind of a complete mess. It was a couple days before Thanksgiving, so I had a few days to kind of get the house ready to go again. So I've organized the furniture. I put up all the, you know, stuff on the walls that needed to get put up. And then it made me, because it looked so clean and neat, it made me want to purge the house. So I've been kind of methodically going through my things and getting rid of stuff that I'm not using and cleaning out closets and things like that. Because I feel like, as with my knitting, I have lots of things and they're just sitting there and I'm not working on them or I'm not doing them. So it's really kind of my goal to purge the house, purge my knitting projects, my works in progress. And that, I think, is going to be my goal for the new year or the next, you know, month or so coming up. I did say I wasn't going to, I did say I wasn't going to cast on any new projects, but I lied. But I did finish some projects this time, guys. I have quite a few to show you, and we'll just start and jump right in. If you guys are not aware as of now, this is a knitting podcast, and sometimes I'll talk about other crafts that I'm into, but mostly about knitting, so I hope you enjoy it, and if you do, please subscribe to the channel. If you're one of my followers, thank you so much for coming back and watching and, you know, keeping me motivated. And I just love it. I love being here with you guys. And so I hope you're enjoying it as well. So I have a finished object that I am wearing. This is my building blocks shawl. Yay, it's done. Oh my goodness. That last section, it took me so long. It took me almost the entire 2 weeks. And then the bind off, which is an I-cord bind off, it took me 2 days because obviously it was before Thanksgiving that I was doing it. And but for every stitch you're binding off, you are having to knit it three times. So you knit three, and in each of those three, you're binding off one, and then you have to move them all back, and then you knit three, and then you're just binding off one. So for every three stitches you're knitting, you're just binding off one. So you're having to do everything three times in order to get them bound off. But it turned out great. I will kind of see if I can show you guys. I love it. The colors are gorgeous. I think that's the back. This is the front, and I did the medium. I can't even, I mean, it's seriously longer than my arm span. So here is one end, and then we go all the way across, and I have to kind of adjust now, and here is the other. So literally when I wrap it around like this, I have these really long tails, which is fine because then I just kind of wrap those up here and sort of tuck it in over here, and then wrap this one up here, tuck it in, and there, it's perfect. It's so soft, so lovely, and it was a really fun knit along. It was the Stephen West building block shawl. I did I used Madeline Tosh Merino Light, and I used the teal color is called esoteric. The light pink here is called posy. The creamy gray is called dust weaver. And this purple blue kind of, tonal here is coal seam. So, it's really lovely. It's super cozy. And I've had quite a few compliments on it already, and I've only had it completed for a couple days. So I've just been wearing it like crazy, which is good. Because that's what it's for, right? Wear like crazy. So I was really excited to get that done. I used a US size 4, which is, I think, what the pattern calls for. And I'm really happy to be finished with it. And I'm excited to move on to another project just because I have finished with something. So I'm going to try to go through some of my works in progress and try to work on those. So that's one finished object that I have to show you guys. Very, very cool. I had so much fun doing that. It did take me a long time. And the very last bit, that's the worst part of a shawl ever. It's the black hole, right? Where you're just knitting and knitting and knitting and you're not getting anywhere at all. It's awful. Anyway, so my next finished object is not a complete project, but it is finished. Some people might call it a half object, but I did finish one sock. It's a vanilla sock in Ba Yarns, La Jolla base, and the color is Hanalei Bay. It's this lovely blue, dark blue with gray and purple, and I did kind of like a short sock, cuff sock. I started at the cuff, did a knit one, purl one ribbing, and then worked straight for a couple inches, not very far, and then worked the heel flap, which is just like a standard slip stitch heel flap. And then did the turn and the gusset. And it started to stripe out really nice at the bottom. And I remember I was telling you guys at first I wasn't really sure whether I was liking this or not. How I thought that the top part or the cuff part was going to be too big. And it's not so big that it slouches on my foot, but it is not snug. So when I got to the gusset part, I decreased down. So I started with 60 stitches here. And then at the end of the gusset, I decreased down to 56 stitches. And that seemed to be a nice snug fit on my foot. And then I worked down and did a toe, to the toe. So I've got one sock done. It's not a full project, but it is a finished object. And I think it counts. Because if you're one of those people who does single socks only, then you have a bunch that are mismatched and I could just throw it in my bin but I will get another one done. I have, I want to have a matching pair, even though I'm not really fond of knitting vanilla socks. This was my project for when I was at the Quilt Craft and Sewing Festival. It was perfect because I did the hard bits like the heel turn and stuff when I was at the hotel, and then when I was at the show I was able to just knit mindlessly and not have to worry about it, and I could talk to people and do the things, put it down and not lose track, because I've tried that the last time. I tried making a pair of fingerless gloves the last time that I was there or at one of the shows, and I could follow the pattern very well. It was a pattern I'd done multiple times, but I couldn't keep track of my rows that well, and usually I do a lot of the tracking in my head. I'm not very good at remembering to mark the row down when I'm done, So a lot of times I just do it by sight. And I ended up making my second fingerless glove a little bit shorter than the first one. And that, it bothers me. It's almost to the point where I want to take it out and redo it. But I don't think I'm going to because it's already done and I'm just, you know, whatever. It's fine. But it bothers me a little bit because I feel like I can notice it. I notice it. I know that it's not quite the same length and it doesn't feel the same way on my hands. So it's a little frustrating. So I wanted to do something plain to make sure that I was, not losing track and able to do a solid project while I was there. So this is really good. So that's my second one. Yay. I love finished objects. Feel like it's been a long time coming in some of these things. The other thing I finished is actually a new project that I've been working on, and it's sort of a project in stages, and I just realized that I left my book that had the pattern in it downstairs. So I'm going to pause for just a moment. I'm actually going to go make myself a cup of coffee, I think, because that is going to amp up my game here. And I will be back with the pattern, and I will show you guys that in just a minute, okay? Okay, I'm back. I have my coffee, and more importantly, I brought up the pattern that I am working on, that I've kind of finished a few things. I still have a couple that I want to make, so let me show you what they are. Let me pull them out here. First of all, I had some leftover cotton yarn from Blue Sky Fibers. I did these four colors in my Caldecott cowl, or no, not Caldecott. What am I talking about? Books with pictures here? No. In my Caledonia cowl that I did over the summer for a knit along with their cotton worsted. And so I had some of this left over and I wasn't really sure what I was going to do with it. And I was perusing old issues of Interweave knits in my collection. And I found some really fun little home projects in the Interweave Spring Edition 2016. So this is the Interweave Knits Spring Edition 2016 magazine. This is where it comes. There's this whole section about modern knits for the home. And so things, you know, like doilies, little trivets and coasters, and I thought that would be really fun. So there was this particular trivet and coaster set that I really liked the look of. Let me see if I can find the page with the pictures on it. So it's these pinwheel coasters and trivet set. And I just thought they were so cute. And I, you know, the colors are very similar to what my colors are here. So I thought I would make myself some coasters and a trivet. Now, I don't have any coasters in my house. I have wanted coasters, but I am not super picky about putting drinks down on tables without a coaster. So I've never really had it. I know that's horrible because you can end up with, you know, rings on your wooden furniture and stuff, but I haven't really been very picky about it or had that much of a problem with it. So, but anyway, I've still wanted some coasters because I think it's a good idea. So the first part of the project I did, I made the trivet. So this is my trivet and it was so cute and so fast, super easy, which is also what I wanted. So I can kind of excuse the fact that I cast on a brand new project because I also finished a brand new project really fast, like in an hour. So you work these little pinwheel sections in short rows and you work yourself all the way around and then you do some decreases here. So kind of cool, pretty neat cotton trivet. So I used all the colors for that. So this is a light pink. I think it was called Shell. I can't remember if this is aqua or turquoise. And I can't remember the name of the pink. Yeah, I don't remember. It's like hot pink though, you know. So anyway, it was very fast, very fun. And I had also the brown. So I thought I would do coasters with all of the solid colors here, but with the brown as its accent. So I just have two right now. Aren't they so cute? They are, it's just garter stitch so fast. I was actually planning on casting on. I need to do one in the light pink now with a brown center and a hot pink, or sorry, light pink with the brown accents around and a hot pink center. And I will have three, you know, little matching coasters. I don't know if three is quite enough. I might keep making them until I run out, just because my kids have been taking them and like flinging them like they're ninja stars or something. And so I'm sure they will get lost in the process. But this is the back, so it's not as pretty on the back, but I've woven in lots of ends to weave in. That is the only thing with it, lots of ends to weave in. But so cute. I just thought they were super fun. And again, super fast and something that I could say, okay, well, it's not that big of a deal that I cast on some new projects because I finished these projects. And so I had them to share with you. And they are so, so fun. This one reminds me of a circus tent. It like literally reminds me of the Big Top circus tent, the bright colors. And I just love these little coasters as well. And they would be great gifts for people. Oh, I have a ghost in the house. I have no idea how the door opened, but I think I must not have closed it all the way. And I either have a ghost or my cat came in. Get that closed. So silly. Anyway, so that is a good present though. Like if you're looking for something like, and you don't know what to do for somebody and you want some fast stuff, like super fast, super cute coaster set you could just make up real fast for somebody. I think it's pretty cool. My mom saw the trivet and she's like, I want one of those. So it's a hit if my mom likes it for sure. That's my last finished object, too. I have one work in progress that I've been actively working on since last podcast, and that is in my You So-and-So bag with the little sheep, knitting sheep on it, and it is my custom fit sweater cardigan that I'm making, the one I'm calling Murder and Mozzarella cardigan. So I haven't gotten too much further than where I showed you guys last time. I'm working on the back here. I've done the decreases. I've done through the straight, and now I am on to increasing again for the back. And I'm doing just like a sort of like broken rib design, split up with these little small sections of stockinette, and it's going to have really, it just has really great texture, really lovely. The color is coming out great. It's Sweet Georgia worsted in the coral rose colorway. And I know I talked so much about custom knits last time, the custom sweater generator, and I really love it. And the patterns are so easy to follow. They tell you exactly how many rows you need to go to get to the right area for the decrease. It's great because you don't have to worry about the pattern. Like my waist is a little bit off from a lot of like normal waists, or I'm shorter waisted than some people. So then my waist decreases are perfect for my proportions. They're exactly right, which is so great. So if you haven't checked the custom fit out, you should. You really should. So this is the back of my Murder and Mozzarella cardigan. I did not work on this at all in Puyallup. I brought it with me, but I focused mostly on the sock because it was easy and I was super busy there. And so now this is going to be what I'm going to be trying to finish up. And like I said, I've got some other knitting projects that I'm going to be pulling out and showing you guys that are things that are old works in progress that I'm going to try to be cleaning up here. And if I'm not going to be doing them, I'm going to be ripping them out and starting afresh with something else, because there's too many projects right now that are just half finished on the needles, and I really want to get that kind of stuff done. So that is the goal for this upcoming month, next couple months, hopefully, is to finish up these projects that are just sitting around and languishing in bags and closets. And in fact, I have a couple in this room here that I'm thinking about pulling out, and I'm going to show you guys. But first, before I do that, because that's all I have like that's actively being worked on, before I do that, I want to show you guys something that's really fun that I did work on this week that I finished. And it's not a knitting project at all. It's another form of crafting. It's kind of, I would call it maybe scrapbooking of a sort. And give you a little backstory here. So my husband and I have been married for 13 years. It'll be 14 years in May. And for my wedding present from my sister-in-law, who's lovely, she got me a family tree kit, like a genealogical family tree kit. It came, it was beautiful. It was from Red Envelope, and it was this, it came with this big giant frame, and it came with kind of a mat that had like a tree and branches coming off the tree. And then you had all these little different colored, two colored leaves, blues and greens. And you were supposed, they, and then a template to follow. So the tree, base of the tree had either you or your children. And so I put my children on the base of the tree. And then the two main branches of the tree were supposed to be you. And then all the leaves coming off of it went off in these little branches that were, you know, grandparents and great grandparents and things like that. So she had given me this project, and it just sat in the box in the back of a closet, and it happened to be a closet that I cleaned out. And I was like, you know, keep purging and getting rid of things, and I thought, you know what, I'm just gonna do this. I'm gonna pull it out. I'm gonna do it. I also had her copy, or her mom's copy, of their family tree, so I already had a lot to go from on at least my husband's side of the family, which I guess his grandmother had done family trees for all her children, and they were specific for each family. So if that person wasn't married, then it was just like that person's name and then the parents, and then the family tree kind of expanded from there. If that person was married, it was the children, the two parents, and then the family trees, you know, went along. And it was a very just lovely, you know, little family tree. So this one's a little bit more intricate. Well, I guess not intricate, because hers was very intricate too. It was just, this is more, not just filling in like a set template, like you had to kind of create the template. So I had that to start from, and I knew that my aunt had done some family research on ancestry.com, and my husband's uncle had done some stuff on ancestry.com, so I was able to kind of get some more. I knew that I had access to more information. So I started filling out the family tree, and then talked to my dad and my mom about, you know, okay, what were your parents' full names, and do you remember their birthdays? And surprisingly, they had a hard time remembering their birthdays and you know, than their grandparents' names. I mean, my parents are kind of older. They're, my mom is going to be 70, let's see, she's born in, she's going to be 73 in February, and my dad is going to be 77 next year. So they, you know, as they're getting older, they're not quite remembering all those things. And plus, my grandparents have been passed away now for almost 18 years. Maybe, well, no, longer, because, no, 20 years for my mom's side, and then about 18 years or so for my dad's last grandmother. So it's been a really long time since they've been around. I remember them. I was old enough still, so I know their names, and I know that my mom had talked about her grandparents, so I kind of knew their names too, but I didn't know anything else about them. So when I asked my dad about all this stuff, he calls me the next morning and he's like, okay, I got us an Ancestry.com account for a month. I just paid for a month because you have to pay for it. And it's not cheap. I think it was like $20 for the month, which, you know, if you're just going to use it for the month, that's not that bad. But I mean, if you were going to continually do all this research, that it could get kind of expensive. So he's like, I've already got it all filled out, and he gave me his information, and so I was able to get this family tree thing done really fast. And I had lots of good information, and it was super fun. So this, oh, there's going to be really bad glare, is the family tree that I finished. And isn't it so awesome, you guys? Oh, it's so bad with the glare, but it was such a lovely piece. And it's so, like, the lines are so clean, and it's beautifully done. I had to be really careful with my handwriting, and I had to rewrite lots of different things. But I finished something that has been sitting in my closet for almost 14 years. So, super excited about that, because that's just one project that has been languishing in the closet. Like I said, I've got lots of them. But, so I was very, very excited to get that one finished as well. So I'm going to pause for just a minute because I want to pull out a few of the other things that I'm thinking of kind of picking back up again and show you guys those projects as well. So hang on. Okay, so the first project I'm thinking about restarting is a shawl pattern that I was designing myself. So I had all these handwritten notes on how this was gonna go. I don't know if I'll be able to recreate what I've already done, but I know I can pick up where I left off. And it may be just something that I never actually write down on paper or produce as a pattern, but it might be. I think I actually saved. I went at one point and wrote up every single line as like a Word document on my old computer, I think. And I still have my old computer. So I think I'm going to try to pull that out, print it, and, you know, or scan it into my new computer, whatever I need to do, or email it, or, you know, whatever you do in the techie world to get something from an old computer to a new computer. I don't know how that goes, but it's a out of Neighborhood Fiber Company in a lace weight yarn in this hot pink, and honestly, don't know what it's called because I don't have the ball band anymore. I must have taken it out at some point. Beautiful hot pink color, and I think I originally bought this pink to do the Imagine When shawl because I had seen at Vogue Knitting Live up in Seattle a couple years ago, I had seen the Imagine When shawl done in this color and in this yarn, and it was gorgeous. But it turned out that I decided to do something different, and I was exploring shawl structure and creativity. So this is kind of what I've got so far. At this point, it's kind of just like a little kerchief. Maybe I could finish it up and wear it like that. No, but I don't think I would. So I think the needle I'm using is a 3, maybe. So it's an Addy. I don't honestly remember. This is, like I said, been 2 years kind of sitting. And it's this gorgeous little pattern. And, you know, with a little bit of a lace design. And I was doing some kind of kookadook things with the lace. At this point, I think I was going to, I don't know if you guys can see that, but I was going to stop doing the zig. I had done straight, and then I was going to stop doing the zigzag, and then I was just start going straight again. But see, I'm not sure, you know, how it's working out or if it will end up being big enough, but it doesn't matter because I'm going to finish it. I'm going to just knit all the yarn until I'm done. The reason I stopped working on this, this is kind of a stupid reason, but I had left it out on the floor, I think, next to the couch, and the cleaners came by, and my cleaners must have sucked the yarn up into the vacuum cleaner, and it broke the yarn, obviously, when they were trying to remove it, I bet. So I don't know why I stopped. I could have just re-added added the yarn back in. I mean, it's not that big of a deal. And I actually had thought about like learning how to do that magic knot, which I know how to do, but I'm not sure how secure that is. I think I tried it on, actually had to try it on the binding of this one because it was so thin in one area, the single ply, that it split apart as I was pulling the yarn to bind off. And then I was at the end of this yarn thing and I had to quickly add it in. So I tried the loop, but then I saw later as I looked back that it had come apart. And so I had to like knot it differently. And I don't know how secure that magic knot is. But so I had considered just adding it in as magic knot. But I think I'm just going to add it back in and start working on the pattern because it was very repetitive and pretty easy. You know, it had like an increase here on the edges and it's your standard triangle. And I really like triangle shawls. I don't know how big this is going to end up because I honestly don't know how much yarn is left. I felt like it was taking a long time to even get to this point, but that's because I was focusing also on the design aspect and writing all that stuff down. So this is kind of the next pull out of the closet thing I think I'm going to work on. I think that'll work. I really want to finish it. It's been sitting there and I'd love it. I'd love to not undo it all and figure out something else. So yeah, I think I'm going to start back up on that one. And then the other thing I was thinking about was I have this little bit of patchwork going on here. And this is supposed to be, there's that hippopotamus that's made out of like granny squares, the crocheted like granny squares. Same gal, I can't even remember the name of it, but I'll try to put it in the show notes. Same gal had done it also in a knitted version, which I could have done the granny squares just fine too, but I wanted to do a knitted version. I was using a US size 1. I do remember that because I was using my Chow Goo US size 1 40 inch magic loop. And you just like, you know, it's like one of those little blankets, but you're making it in adding these things in a specific way that you get a hippopotamus at the end of it. So I've got two legs here at the back. You can see I've got these little like pouchy like legs. This is the butt right here. And then this is supposed to go up and kind of over, if I recall correctly. But yeah, I had all this leftover sock yarn and I thought, oh, that'd be perfect. I could totally do that. So I'm working on that. I worked on that. I was going to give it to somebody as a baby shower gift. But then I think I found out the person was having a boy, and I thought, oh, that's not going to work if she's having a boy, because I've got it's all pinks and purples and blues. But my niece, I could probably give it to my niece. She would probably like it as a little, like, Christmas thing. So I'm going to try maybe to finish that. Look, it's like almost the same matchy colors as my shawl here. I really like these colors, these purples and pinks and blues. And like I said, I was just using up, I had some leftover stuff. Like here, I was using up, I thought I had, this was a whole skein of Miss Babs pink that I had started using for something else, but I thought it would look really cute with that. You know, I've got like some of this. I was just gonna try to use up my squares of things, you know. So I started doing all the same colors, but then I decided that I would just add these other ones because some of them are really cute and really pretty and they have like the same look to them. So that is one of the other projects that I was gonna work on. However, in order to do that, because I was using my Chow Goose, I have to finish the second sock for my sister of the Kandahar socks. So that is the other thing that I'm going to start working on. I had misplaced the book, but I found the book, and I'm going to start finishing up on those two. Because I have one sock down, and I think I could be quick if I just, like, you know, put my mind to it. So that is what I'm doing, guys. Those are the things. Also, I just want to say a big thank you to one of my viewers. You know who you are. I don't want to give your name away. I didn't ask her if I could. So I just want to say a big thank you to one of my viewers who gifted me this lovely, lovely shawl pattern on Ravelry. And I'm excited about that. So I have this really pretty green lace yarn that I think I was going to do it in. It's sort of just been sitting in my closet. So, but that is going to have to wait. I really, truly think the pattern is beautiful. And thank you so much because it was such a surprise and so great. I really want, I need to get some of these other things that are on the needles done. So that's what the plan is. So hopefully in the next couple weeks, you guys will see more progress on those few items that I just showed you. And if any of you guys are out there also debating on whether or not you should pull out some of those old projects that you're working on, maybe we could do a knit along or something to inspire us all to revive some of those projects. I know there have been a couple that have been like that. So if you're tired of that, we won't do it. But if you're interested in something like that, just message me on the bottom here or on Ravelry and let me know if you're interested or in the group page. And we could definitely get that started. And also, if there are any makers out there who would love to donate something to the podcast for gifts and things like that, I would truly appreciate that. I did hit 200 subscribers, and I want to do a 200 subscriber giveaway, but I don't have anything yet that I think is cool enough to give as a giveaway prize. So I'm going to be working on putting together a giveaway prize for that. So if there are any makers out there who would love to donate to that, that would be awesome. Contact me as well. And you guys, it's been another great day. And as always, I'm more inspired than ever to jump into some of these projects and see what you guys are doing, see what everybody else out there in the community is working on right now. I know right now is a big gift time for a lot of people. So good luck with all of that and all of your holiday stuff. And I will see you guys again in a couple weeks where we'll see how much progress I've made on these things. Anyway, thanks everyone. Have a great day. Bye.